Hello guys, welcome back to the channel and to a new video. Today we are going to have a look at a new AUR helper called Paru. Paru is actually based on Rust and it's using the same architecture as EA, but it's new and it's gonna be developed in the future, whereas EA is still available and it's gonna be still available, but probably will not be developed as much, at least this according to the developers. Now, without further ado, let's jump into the terminal and see how Paru works. So guys, welcome back to my desktop again. So here we are on an Arch Linux desktop and the topic of this video is gonna be another helper for the AUR. So to make things clear first, let me just say that if you want to install packages from the main repositories, please use pacman. Pacman is the official package manager for Arch Linux and it should be used for installing packages from the main repositories. If you want to install packages from the AUR, you can of course use the git clone command to clone the packages and then use the make package -si option to build the package yourself. Now, of course, we have other options for the AUR and that is to use the so-called helper. Now, one of the most popular helpers for the AUR has been EA. EA was developed by two developers and recently one of these developers left the project and started to work on another package and you can find information about it on Reddit. So let me open up here Firefox very quickly and let me go full screen and let me search here for Paru, which is the new name of the new helper, and then Arch Reddit. And let's click here on the first link. Now this post is 2 months old and you can see here one of the developers is saying, last week I announced my new AUR helper Paru. Since then a lot of testing has gone in and a lot of bugs fixed by me and help from contributors. So now Paru reached version 1.0.0. Now it's also mentioned here that this developer no longer plans to work on EA. And EA has been co-developed with another developer over the past 3 years. Now, EA will still exist, and as it says here, there is no panic and move away from EA, but just don't expect much new development on it. So it does not mean that you cannot use EA anymore. Of course, you can use it, but Paru going forward is going to be developed probably more than EA. So in this video, I'm just going to give you an overlook of Paru and how you can install it and use it by following the instructions on GitHub from the project. So let me type in here the browser, Paru GitHub, and hit enter. And who we have here, the first link, it's the homepage of the project. And we can see the project here. So one of the differences between Paru and EA is that Paru is actually written in Rust, whereas actually EA is written in Go. So we have two different programming languages there, and that's fine. So we can move down here and it tells you how we can install Paru. So to install Paru, you need to have the base devel package already installed, which if you followed one of my guides, you should have already installed. And then we have here some of the options. Well, let me actually pull this on the left and open up a terminal here and pull this terminal on the right and increase the font sizes. So let's go ahead and install Paru. So to do this, we're going to use the git clone command to clone the repository. So let's type in git clone and then https://, then aur.archlinux.org/paru, and then we can hit enter. Take a moment here to clone. There you go. Now we can move into the Paru directory, which was just created. So let's type in cd and then Paru and hit enter. And we can make the package now by typing in make pkg-si and then pkg build and then hit enter. Now it's going to take a moment to start up. And we need to enter our sudo password. And now we can choose the repository. As you can see, this is for the dependency. It's Rust. We need to install Rust. So let's select here the number 1. And then we can proceed and install Rust. So this is going to take a second. And now it's basically downloading and building the Paru package. Now this is going to take probably 1 to 2 minutes, depending also on how fast your machine is. So I'm going to take a small break here, guys. And I'll be back with you when it's done. So building the package is done. Now we can proceed with the installation, which is going to take a second. There you go. And Paru is now installed. So let's get out of the directory here and clean up the terminal. Now let's have a look here at some of the general tips, which might be very handy. So of course, there is a man page for Paru and also paru.conf. And I definitely encourage you to explore them if you want to have more technical details and more information about the application. We have also the option of colors. Now here it says Paru only enables color if color is enabled in Pacman. So to use colors in Paru, we need to enable color in Pacman. Now you might not be aware, but there is a color option in the pacman.com file. So let me show you there. Let's type in sudo vim. I'm using vim here, but you can use any other editor of your choice. And the pacman.com file is under the etc directory. So let's type in /etc/pacman.conf and hit enter, and let's search here for color, and as you can see, it's right there. So what we need to do here, we need to uncomment this line, so by deleting the hashtag here, and then we can save the file and exit vim, and let's try it out. For example, if we would type in now sudo pacman-s, and let's say I want to install a package, let me install vifm, which is a file browser based on vim, and then hit enter. And as you can see, we have already some colors there on the left side, and then proceed with the installation, and the installation is done. So we have now colors also in Pacman. So we enable this option there. Now let's clean up the terminal and go to the second here. So this is also very interesting, the file-based review. So to get a more advanced review process, enable the file manager option in the paru.com file. So let's do that. Let's type in sudo vim /etc, because configuration files in Linux are always under the etc directory, and then paru.conf and hit enter. And let's search here for file manager, which is right down there. So we need to basically delete again here the hashtag. Now, the thing here is that we need to also delete the hashtag on the bin option here. Otherwise, we get an error when we try to install a package. So as a file manager, you can choose whichever file manager you want. As you can see here, I have already vifm, which I just installed. So I will leave this as it is. And I will show you afterwards what this option does. So we can save now the file and exit vim. Now, the other option which is definitely useful is the flip search order. Now, by default here, it's going to show you the most relevant package on the top of the list, and the last one is going to be the less relevant package. The problem is when you're searching for something, for example, let's say that we want to install Spotify here. Let's type in Paru and then Spotify and hit enter. Now you can see here we have the last package on the line. It's the number 89, and it's a Spotify Connect enable headless client, which is not what we want. So if you scroll up here to the number one, you can see that's what we want. AUR Spotify, a proprietary music streaming service. So we want to basically flip the search order. So let me type in here, Control C, clean up the terminal, and change the option again in the paru.com file. So let me pull up here the last two commands and hit enter. And I want to basically go up here and uncomment this bottom up option by deleting the hashtag. Now we can save the file and exit vim. And if I try again to install Spotify this time, you can see I get the first option, the most relevant option on the last line. And it's much easier for me to see. Now let's say that we want to try to install Spotify. So I'm just going to install here the number one and hit enter. And for the default repository, I'm going to choose also the number one here. And as you can see here, before installing, it says proceed to review. So let's hit Y here to proceed. And as you can see, it's opening up the vifm file manager, and it shows me the content basically of the file. So if I want to see the package build, for example, I can go down here and hit enter. And this is how it looks like. So I can explore this, and if I see some things that I need to change, I can go then into the package build and make the changes right here. But in my case, I don't need to do this, so I'm just going to hit colon Q here to exit, and again colon Q to exit vifm. And I could proceed also by installing Spotify. But for now, let me type in N here and hit enter. and clean up the terminal. Now we still have one option here which I would like to mention, and that is to install BAT to enable syntax highlighting during package build. Well, let me show you actually BAT first. Let's install it. This is from the main repository. So let's type in sudo pacman-s and then BAT and hit enter. Let's proceed with the installation. So what BAT does basically, it offers actually syntax highlighting on the cat command. So let me actually here close for now Firefox and go full screen with my terminal. And let's type in, for example, bat /etc/fstab. This is normally what I would do with a cat command to show the content of the fstab file. But by using the bat command, look what happens. So I get my fstab file, but with syntax highlighting and column numbers on the left side. So it's a little bit better to look at, and it's a bit easier if you want to explore the files and not opening an editor. So let's clean up the terminal and try to install now again Spotify. So Paru Spotify will install Spotify. So again, I'm going to choose the package number 1. And for the AUR repository, I'm going to use the number 1. And I will proceed to review. I'm going to go down here to the package build one more time and I'll have a look at it, and I see, and I think everything here looks good. So I can just hit colon Q here, and again colon Q to exit VIFM and proceed with the installation. So let's go ahead and do that. I need to import the key here, so I'm just going to hit Y and it's going to take a second, and now proceed with the installation of certain dependencies. So it's going to do that, and now it's going to install Spotify. So while it's doing this, let me pull up again Firefox because I want to show you some other things here. So let me go full screen and I'm going to type in again here Paru GitHub to go to the homepage. And don't forget here, we have also some examples that we can explore. So Paru target basically installs the package that you specify in the target here. Paru is an alias for paru-syu. So by typing paru in the terminal, you're basically going to update your system from the main repositories and from the AUR. By using paru-sua, you're going to upgrade the packages from the AUR, and you have also some other options here. Now let's close this and go back to our terminal and see if it's done. There you go, Spotify was now installed. So let me check this very quickly. If I type in here Spotify, you can see we have it there and it's up and running. So let me close this. So as we saw before, by typing in here paru, we are updating our system. And there is one which was not mentioned there, but it's mentioned of course in the man pages. It's paru-c, which is going to basically delete unwanted dependencies. So if I hit enter here, it's going to remove Rust, which was used to build Paru. So I'm just going to hit Y here, and it's going to remove Rust. Now, another thing which I would like to mention is the man pages. So we have man pages for Paru and paru.conf. I definitely encourage you to explore this. So if I type in here man paru, we have a very nice main page here, which is going to explain you how to use all the options that we have available. So for example, here you see another one, which is very interesting, the option -sc. Paru will also clean the cache AOR packages and any untracked file in the cache. We had such an option also in Yay, and it's nice to have it also here in Paru. And we have the clean option here, which is removing unneeded dependencies, which is the one I just showed you. And there are also many others. Another one that is very important is manparu.conf, which is going to explain you all the options in the .conf file of Paru. So for example, here, if we search for file manager, you can see this is the one we used before, and this enables FM review, file manager review mode, where package build review is done using the file manager specified by command. Now, just don't forget also to enable the bin line in the .conf file, otherwise it will work. I'm going to show you this one more time. If we type in sudo vim/etc/paru.conf, you can see here we enable the file manager option and we enabled also the bin parameter. Otherwise, the file manager option will not work and Paru will give you an error. So this is all there is to Paru. So it's an helper for the AUR, which is now basically new. And you can try it out and let me know what you think about in the comments below. And if you try it out and you find any bug or anything else, also go to the GitHub project and post your findings there. It will help the developer develop further this application. So there you go, guys. This is Paru, the new helper for the AUR. Again, if you're using Yay, don't panic. This is gonna be anyway still available. But if you wanna go ahead and explore Paru, definitely do that and let me know what you think about it in the comments below. I hope you liked this video, guys. If you did, please hit the thumbs up and subs to the channel if you haven't already. Subs always help me out. And if you want to support my work, you can do so by visiting the Patreon website or you can donate via PayPal as well. Thank you so much for watching the video, guys, and I'll see you very soon in the next one.